Good afternoon, students. In the last class, we had done definition and meaning of science, as well as what do we mean by the nature of science. Under this, we had discussed about science is a particular way of looking at nature and interdisciplinary nature of science. Today, we will move forward and we will discuss about next point. Scientific ideas are subject to change, tentativeness. Science is a process for producing knowledge. The process depends on making careful observations of phenomena and on inventing theories for making sense out of those observations. Change in knowledge is inevitable. Here, inevitable means certain to happen or unavoidable. Means change in knowledge is unavoidable. That is, it will definitely certain to happen. It is certain to happen because new observations may challenge prevailing theories. In science, testing and improving and occasional discarding of theories, whether new or old, go on all the time. This we may understand by taking an example of structure of atom. At first, Dalton has proposed the postulates for atomic structure, and then some limitations has come out, and then Thomson model came regarding the structure of atom, and after that Rutherford's model. So these shows the tentativeness nature of science. Observation and inference. Observation involves gathering information using the five senses, while inference are explanation based on observation and prior knowledge. Empirical evidence. Scientific knowledge is derived from data and evidence gathered by observation and experimentation. See, students, these are the points for nature of science. Non-dogmatic. Non-dogmatic means never requires idea to be accepted on belief or faith. That means science does not believe or blind faith on any idea. It needs facts, evidence and proof. Science is a dynamic body of knowledge. Newer disciplines are being discovered and established every day, and the older one are being enriched by researches carried out in institutes of higher learning, not only in volume of knowledge increasing at a furious pace, but the newer knowledge is also replacing some of the older knowledge. Science is a truly international enterprise. Men and women of all countries participate in the process of science and its applications. Most big projects in science are undertaken by a team of scientists drawn from many countries. This is because the human and financial resources need for most big projects are beyond the reach of any single country. Now, science promotes skepticism. Scientists look at everything with suspicion. Every new observation, a new theory is received with a lot of skepticism. A new observation is accepted only when experimental observations have been checked by independent individuals or group at various place with identical results. यहाँ suspect skepticism का मतलब हुआ संदेहात्मक दृष्टि से देखना. जब कोई एक नया जब कोई थ्योरी आती है सामने, तो उसे तब तक एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया जाता है कि जब तक कि हर एक साइंटिस्ट जहाँ जहाँ वो है उसे अपने तरह अपने लेवल पर उसे टेस्ट ना कर ले और आइडेंटिकल यानी सेम रिजल्ट ना आ जाए, या और अ ग्रुप ऑफ साइंटिस्ट या कोई एक जगह या दूसरे जगह के कोई साइंटिस्ट उस थ्योरी को अपने खुद से टेस्ट करके उसके रिजल्ट को देखे ना, चेक ना करे, तब तक उस चीज़ को वो एक्सेप्ट नहीं की जाती है थ्योरीज. साइंस एज अ प्रोसेस एज वेल एज अ प्रोडक्ट. In science, the ways of gathering information, thinking, measuring, problem solving are called process of science. Basic process of science are observation, comparison, classification, communication, measurement, estimation, and prediction. Whatever information or ideas we acquire through various process of science form the product of science. Science viewed as a method of inquiry. According to Carl Pearson, the scientific method involves the following six steps: identification of the problem, gathering observation relevant to the problem on hand, statement of a hypothesis based on observations gathered. Here, hypothesis means a tentative solution of a problem, किसी भी समस्या का संभावित solution. Samadhan. Testable predictions of other related observable phenomena are developed from the hypothesis. Here, this means the tools and techniques for data collection as well as analysis of data should be developed over here. Now, the hypothesis is tested through observations. And as a result of empirical observation, that means as a result of the observation, the hypothesis is supported or rejected or modified. So these are a few points regarding nature of science. So, now thank you. Have a wonderful day. In next class, we will meet with another topic.